The night sky above Ukraine can appear calm until sirens pierce the silence. From far away, beyond the horizon, a threat awakens. It is not a fighter jet, not a swarm of drones, but a giant shadow that never needs to cross into enemy territory. This is the Tupolev Tu-160, known in Russia as the White Swan. It does not need to approach its target. Instead, it releases long-range cruise missiles from hundreds of kilometers away, silent weapons that skim the earth, weaving through valleys, unseen by radar, until they strike. The Tu-160 is not only an aircraft, it is a message of power. NATO calls it the Blackjack, a darker name reflecting the unease it spreads across the globe. Each time this bomber leaves its runway, the world watches closely, uncertain of what might come next. Capable of carrying up to 40 tons of weapons, the Tu-160 represents both technological achievement and strategic intimidation. And in the war in Ukraine, its presence has once again reminded the world of the terrifying reality of long-range air power. The Tu-160 was born during the Cold War in the 1970s when the Soviet Union sought a response to America's B-1 bomber. Development was ambitious, a massive supersonic aircraft with variable sweep wings, advanced engines, and the ability to carry nuclear weapons across continents. The first flight came in 1981, and by 1987, it entered service. It quickly became the largest and fastest supersonic bomber in the world. After the Soviet collapse, many Tu-160s were stranded in Ukraine. Some were scrapped, while others were transferred back to Russia under political agreements. Today, Russia operates around 16 to 19 active aircraft with an ongoing upgrade program. The modernized Tu-160M and Tu-160M2 feature new avionics, improved radar systems, digital navigation, and more efficient NK-32 engines. These upgrades are designed to keep the bomber relevant well into the 21st century. The White Swan may have been designed decades ago, but with modernization, it still casts a long shadow across the skies of Europe and beyond. At first glance, the Tu-160 is massive, 54 meters long, with wings that can sweep from 35 to 55 meters in span. Its maximum takeoff weight reaches nearly 275 tons, making it heavier than most commercial airliners. The key to its performance lies in its variable sweep wings, which allow it to fly efficiently at both subsonic and supersonic speeds. Powered by four NK-32 afterburning turbofan engines, the Tu-160 can reach Mach 2.05, over twice the speed of sound. But its true strength lies not in speed alone, but in endurance. With a range of over 12,000 kilometers without refueling, the bomber can cross continents, striking targets anywhere on Earth. Inside its twin weapon bays, it can carry up to 40 tons of payload, the largest capacity of any combat aircraft in history. This combination of size, speed, and range makes the Tu-160 a rare breed, a bomber that can outrun fighters, carry more than any rival, and strike across oceans. The Tu-160's arsenal is designed for standoff strikes, attacking from great distance. Its primary weapons are long-range cruise missiles, one, Kian 55 and Kia 555, nuclear or conventional, with ranges of up to 3,000 kilometers. 2. KH-101 and KA-102, modern missiles with ranges beyond 5,500 kilometers. The KH-101 is conventional, with precision measured in only 5 to 10 meters. The KH-102 is nuclear capable, carrying warheads powerful enough to alter entire regions. 3. Tu-15, a smaller fast missile with quasi-ballistic flight reaching hypersonic speeds. Though capable of carrying free-fall bombs, its focus is clear: launch precision strikes from afar, outside enemy defenses. A single Tu-160 can unleash a storm of cruise missiles, overwhelming defenses, and crippling critical infrastructure. It is this ability to strike accurately from safety that makes the Tu-160 one of the most feared strategic aircraft in the world. The Tu-160 was not built to sneak like the stealthy American B-2. Instead, its survival relies on distance and speed. By launching missiles from well beyond the reach of enemy air defenses, it avoids direct confrontation. Its cruise missiles fly low to the ground, hugging the terrain, making them difficult to track or intercept. Modern upgrades add electronic warfare systems, digital avionics, and limited reductions in radar cross-section. But its true advantage remains in strategy. Attack from thousands of kilometers away, release a wave of missiles, and retreat before the enemy even knows where to look. In military doctrine, the Tu-160 embodies deterrence. It does not need to fight its way through defenses. It overwhelms them from afar, ensuring that any nation facing it must think twice before escalating a conflict. In recent years, the Tu-160 has been used not in theory, but in practice. During the conflict in Ukraine, Russia launched cruise missiles from Tu-160, flying safely within its own territory or over the Caspian Sea. The targets were not deep bunkers or distant battlefields, but infrastructure, power stations, fuel depots, and command centers. The strikes disrupted electricity and communications across Ukraine, leaving millions in darkness. Internationally, each deployment of the Tu-160 is closely monitored. NATO scrambles fighters to intercept whenever these bombers patrol near European airspace. Each flight is a reminder of the risks, the thin line between conventional warfare and nuclear escalation. For civilians, the fear lies not only in the physical damage, but in the uncertainty. The knowledge that a weapon launched from beyond the horizon can alter daily life in an instant is enough to spread unease across entire nations. The Tu-160 is more than a bomber. It is a psychological weapon, a diplomatic signal, and a strategic pillar of Russia's nuclear triad. The Tupolev Tu-160 White Swan stands as both a marvel of engineering and a chilling reminder of human conflict. Its vast wings and powerful engines give it speed, range, and strength unmatched by any other bomber. Its weapons give it precision and devastating potential. Yet, beyond the technical achievements, it represents something deeper: the tension between nations, the fragility of peace, and the terrifying scale of modern warfare. Whenever the White Swan takes flight, the world remembers that in the age of missiles and megatons, safety is never guaranteed.